those two nights.
She always does, but...
Thank you.
This is an Eastern marriage. The sacrament of marriage, unlike in the Western churches. The order of service of marriage would be according to the Markhama Syrian Church in India. It's a rich blend of biblical traditions and teachings as well, and the practices of early church of the East and the customs and traditions of the southern part of India. The service focuses on the sacramental character of God, bringing together man and woman as husband and wife.
For the fulfillment of the joy of the children of the Holy Church, these rings are blessed in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Manavala.
Graciously stretch out his right hand to you with this ring, which is the token of your betrothal. May you obtain from him grace, mercy, and blessings. May blessings and goodness from the hand of Christ remain with you and perfect you throughout your life.
Amen.
May O Lord Jesus Christ mystically stretch out his hand to you. Accept this ring from the hand of the minister, as from the hand of the holy apostle, as a sign of your betrothal, with peace and joy of body and spirit. May you offer praise and glory to him, and to the Father, and to the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
This is beautiful. It really is. So you've asked for this time to not be so much about the biblical picture of marriage that we're already talking about, but to take this time to talk about your greatest treasure and to share your greatest treasure with each of the people here, which is the gospel of Jesus Christ. And we could talk about the gospel of Jesus Christ in its normal story that Jesus, who is our God, was sent from heaven. So the second member of the Trinity, one God, three persons, sent down from heaven to live among us, die for our sin, so that he would make a way for us to be welcomed into the family of God for all eternity. Those of us who are married will attest to the fact that there are some high highs and some low lows in marriage, maybe the highest of all of life. And yet in that, where we will let each other down, that's when we're going to need to be reminded of the gospel of Jesus Christ. And so this is for us, for me as another married, and for all of us out there, that we will continue to need the message of Jesus Christ, the gospel, for our lives. And that's the beauty of his message. The message isn't that God came down and loved those who were worthy of his love. In fact, it's exactly the opposite. Christ came down and loved those who weren't worthy. In fact, the Bible would say it this way, that we love others because he first loved us. That's our greatest treasure that we have. Regardless of how life goes, we are loved by Jesus Christ. And because of that, we can share that love with others. The last thing I'll say here, before we move into the last section here, is that you are also testifying to this with your life. You are about to go to Rwanda for 6 months, and you will have the opportunity to display this gospel to a watching world for the rest of your lives until God comes back or calls you home. And that is a privilege for us to be around you. Let me pray for you. Father, we say thank you for today, that you have led this couple together in this time, in this season, with these families, and brought them together, united them to each other as you, Christ, have united yourself to the church. That's unbelievable. Your people of God were never worthy, and yet you've united yourself to your church, us, the people of God. And so, Father, we pray tonight that we would celebrate that to the fullest extent and see the picture of it in marriage. And Lord, we also pray tonight that if there's any who don't yet know that Jesus Christ is our God, that they would testify that you are theirs. That opportunity is there for them. I even pray that for my own daughter, that she would know you soon. So, Father, we rejoice together today in what you have brought together and what you're doing, and we ask that you would bless this couple this day and for every day until you come back or call them home. And together we all say, Amen.
these crowns, and the heads that are crowned are blessed and perfected in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Vanil ninnor magadam, karthil ninningirangi, manavan en shirasinmel, Kahana chotidunno vanil ninnor magda Karthil ninningirangi Manavalan shirasin mel Kahana chotidunno Vanil ninnor magda, karthil ninningirangi, manavalan shirasin mel, kahana chotidunno.
May the Lord adorn you with the crown of righteousness. May the Lord arm you against all powers of the enemy.
Karthil ninningirangi, manavatti shirasin mel, kahana chotidunno. Karthil ninningirangi, manavatti shirasin mel, kahana chotidunno. Karthil ninningirangi, manavatti shirasin mel, kahana chotidunno.
May the Lord adorn you with the crown of righteousness and with the desirable and imperishable adornment. May you rejoice all your life offering praise to the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Delights in human life, be pleased with your lives and bless your union. May Christ, our heavenly bridegroom, seal your marriage with the true seal of his love. As Christ rejoices in his church, may you rejoice in each other. May the right hand of his blessings be on you and protect you from all trouble. May the angel of peace be with you and keep you from all jealousies that lead to destruction. May the Most High God, who descended on Mount Sinai to make a covenant with the bride, yet called out of Egypt, bless you and this congregation. Let us offer praise to the Lord of heaven and earth now and forevermore.
Amen.
Idan thottathinudaiyo God's mercy and blessings be upon the priests, the deacons, the believers, the bride, the bridegroom, the guests, and the hosts. May the right hand of our Lord Jesus Christ be upon us all forever.
Amen.
Once again, believers, know that this commandment is to you and to all, that each husband among you should always keep in mind the right relationship he owes his wife. For she has left all her kindred to join her husband. Therefore, he must love and cherish her. He must clothe her even if he has to go naked. Feed her even if he has to go hungry. And give her drink even if each wife among you should behave towards her husband in the same manner as he does towards her and honor him accordingly. She must treat him with love and affection in all things. May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ be upon you and all of us here now and forever.
Rebecca, God has united you as husband and wife from this day. You are no longer two, but one. Christian family life is a great privilege and responsibility. So love one another, respect each other, be tolerant, be forgiving, hate evil, hold on to all that is good, be patient in tribulation. Be constant in family prayer. Be diligent in studying the word of God. Practice charity and hospitality. Do always what is noble in the sight of all. Be active participants in corporate worship and regular partakers of Holy Communion. May God help you to rejoice in such a blessed Christian family life. Remember that you, Jayon and Rebecca, you are stewards of God in wealth, time and talents. Therefore, set apart a portion of your income for the needy and the poor and for the mission of the church. When you are blessed with children, nurture them in the love of God. May Almighty God help you to rejoice in such a blessed Christian family life. This is a gift for you. This is a holy Bible which I will give you. And read this Bible regularly. Practice the word of God in your life. Thank you.
May we all arise for the final blessings. You are blessed by the Lord who created the heaven and the earth. May the Lord bless and sanctify you all who attended this divine service with us. May God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit hear and accept our weak and inadequate prayers before His throne of grace.
Amen.
Thus we come to the end of the sacrament.
Now, both James and Rebecca's siblings would lead us in a sweet chorus.
Thank you. and please join me in welcoming the newlyweds, Jayon and Rebecca Abraham. Let's give it one more time.
I said your love
and we'd like to start this off by a welcome speech by the bride's father, Mr. Mark Whaley. Let's hear it for him as he makes his way over.
Well, hello, I'm Mark Whaley. I'm proud father of Rebecca and father-in-law now of Jayon Abraham. We're excited for this day, and we just wanted to take a second and say thank you, all of you, for joining us in celebrating this this event and this really this culmination of the last 18 months, and more than that, the beginning of a wonderful future. So I don't have a long speech other than to just say welcome, enjoy this evening. This is about celebration of this marriage and celebration of their love for each other. So enjoy. Thank you.
Hi, everybody. Hi. I'm Jayon's sister, Cheryl. Hi. And I just want to say I am so excited for y'all, the beautiful couple. Don't they look lovely tonight? So, what a beautiful day it has been, right? Celebrating the love that these two have and just seeing how it reflects the love of Jesus that he has for the church. Jayon Cha, as you move on to this next season, you like those nuts, huh? I have to say thank you for everything you've done for me. You have been my lifelong advisor in finances and career, and especially recently in my walk with Jesus. So even though I miss you every day because you're no longer going to be my roommate, I'll make sure I don't convert your room too much, and I'll save some space for you to come and hang out with me whenever you can. But honestly, you're getting quite the upgrade in roommates. Becca, I know I've said it before, but I am so thankful that God has brought you into not only Jayon's life, but into our family's life. He has used you to change Jayon's life from the moment that y'all met. And I have been firsthand the person, one of the people, to see him fall more and more in love with you every day since. I'm excited to welcome you into our family with open arms, especially as you complete the Abraham sisterhood. So you're the final one. We couldn't have asked God for someone more genuine, someone more after his own heart, and someone that will join our family's mission to glorify Jesus and expand his kingdom. Congratulations, Jayon Cha and Becca. Here's to the many memories our future holds together, and praying for his guidance and his will to be done every step of the way. I love you both.
Hi, everyone. I am Sharon, the youngest of the family. Now, being a little sister in general has its ups and downs. You know, you get the occasional teasing, the beating up, the hey, get out of the way, what are you doing, aka that happened yesterday, and you know, you get all those things. That's a fun part. And you also get the instilling of just life values. I remember when I was in elementary school, Jayon, Chachin, and I we were standing in front of this area where they were just like selling goods at our elementary school. And I had just like a few coins, and then he had a few dollar bills. And then we just like looked at this one gift, and he was just like, oh, you know what? We should buy this for mom. And so even at such a young age, he was already teaching me, hey, like, family is important, and this is the way that we show love through that. And along with that, during my freshman year here in Denton, Jan would come and get me every single Friday afternoon. He would drive 45 minutes all the way to come get me, and we would exchange the hello, how are you, and then I would promptly fall asleep. And then he, week after week, he would just faithfully serve in that way, just with no complaints, just full on love. And so he has just taught me what it looks like to serve and to love, just with no strings attached. And so Becca, that is, and you've heard of just like the ways that we've talked about Jan yesterday, but that is the man that you are marrying, the one who will continue to teach you how to serve, to continue to teach you how to love even deeper. And so Becca, we are thrilled. Actually, thrilled is an understatement. We are just so excited to have you join our family. Even though you felt like part of the family for such a long time, this is just official. So we're super excited to have you as part of our family. Just like Cheryl said, you have completed the sisterhood, so now there are four sisters. So we're super excited. So Jan and Becca, go serve, love, laugh a lot, and get down to Drake. This is day one of y'all's forever here on earth. So we are so excited, and we'll be praying, and we love you two so, so very much.
Thank you, all of you, for being here. Like I have mentioned to you yesterday in the rehearsal dinner, I gave a speech yesterday in the rehearsal dinner. So I am going to have to close it today by saying, well, Becca, you are, we already welcomed you into the family, but today, Jaron and Becca are officially married, so we want to welcome you into our family, not only you, your friends, your lovely family, and everybody is welcome. And Jaron knew the verses that we are read in the church today. Husbands, you're supposed to help me. Love your wives. And I'm very confident he will do just like that. And take good care of Becca. Thank you all, and God bless.
Well, so before Becca met Jayon, a lot of people don't know this, but I distinctly remember us sitting at Casa Hogar Alim, which is an orphanage that we like to go to in Nuevo Laredo. And we were just sitting in the little snack room before we were gonna go to bed. And we were just talking about how we just had to wait for God's timing. And we were just kind of, Becca was unsure like who she was gonna marry and you know where life was taking her. And we were just talking about how God's timing is always perfect. And how, you know, we may just like want to know what God's plan is. But the thing is, if he told us, many of us would just try to beat him there. And so I thought it was so crazy because only a month later did she meet Jayon at the hospital. And I just remember her coming home and telling my mom all about it. And my mom was so excited because she was like, oh my gosh, I've never seen Becca this happy and giddy. And we were just talking about it. And a couple months later, we went back to Casa Hogar with Jayon. And I cannot tell you, just seeing the love that they have, like it literally makes you feel like you're just in a Nicholas Sparks movie. And it's kind of terrible because you're just one of like the side people who like no one really pays attention to, but you want to be the people who are in love. And so they kind of have their own movie scene, and I just always have wanted that, and I think it's so cute. And so I just the one thing that I see in y'all is y'all just have so much passion, and I don't know where it comes from or what motivates you, but I see it in y'all for each other, and I also see it through the things that you believe in and the things that you like hold on to and you think are right. And it's really cool that you're going to go across the world just for something that you think is right and that you think you should do. And I just see that passion coming through you and exiting out. And I think it's also coming from God and out. And so I'm just super excited to see where God takes that, because that's going to be something amazing that he does through you. And I think everyone's going to be a little bit jealous of us, you know. So.
All right, so I'm Allie, Becca's older sister. And when I think about my sweet sister, Becca, I see someone who is sure of who she is and what she likes and what she believes in. Becca, you have a quiet confidence that I've always admired. You're confident that putting your hair up in a whale spout style in fourth grade would be all the rage, and it was. You were confident that purple tights could be cool in high school. They were. You were confident in choosing nursing as your perfect profession, and it is. And now you're confident in your decision to marry Jayon. As someone with this remarkable confidence and track record, you are someone that others want to be on the same team as. Becky, you have been my teammate and my best friend for as long as I can remember. We're 16 months apart, and so really from my earliest memories, Becca is there. You're unbelievably talented, breathtakingly beautiful, and have a compassionate heart for the Lord and for those in need. Again, you want to be with this girl. I remember being little and wanting you with me even to head down to the creepy basement, even though she had this really bad habit of hiding behind walls and jumping out at me, totally freaking me out. I wanted you with me even when we played dress up, and you made me always be the prince to your princess. So, Jayon, I'm really excited that you're taking over that position now. And Jayon, you're just really one lucky guy. I know that you know that, but I just so know that to be true. And you're signing up for a lifetime with Becca, and that's so exciting. Her dry sense of humor will keep you laughing. Her creativity will keep you marveling, and her adventurous spirit will definitely keep you on your toes. Looking back, some of her confident choices, example, the hairdo and the tights may not have been the best. But y'all's marriage definitely is. And you are kind, Jayon, you're intelligent, and to quote you from this past summer, obsessed with her. But it's your groundedness, it's your groundedness in your faith that makes me confident that y'all will have a wonderful, God-honoring marriage and life together. So, love you guys, and we're so excited for you.
So, dear respected Utchins family and friends, I'm Jaffe Abraham. For those of you that haven't met me, I'm Jayon's best man and cooler older brother. I'm honored to be here to celebrate such a wonderful evening with everyone. Everyone looks great. It was a beautiful ceremony. I'd like to extend a special welcome to everyone in celebrating Rebecca and Jayon this evening. On behalf of them, I thank you for your presence, your time, and everyone's prayers here. Now, I know that it's tradition for the best man to roast the groom, make him a little embarrassed, talk all about the shenanigans, but I'm not going to do that. You're my kid brother. I can't do that to you. Instead, I'm going to talk about all the nice things about Jayon and everything that I love about him. No. I waited 3 decades for this, Jayon. Our childhood and teenage years, I felt like I was rescuing a lost puppy. Your nerdiness and your lack of game was appalling, and what a chore raising you right. I tried to make it better by getting you to hang out with me, being the cooler brother, passing on the torch, so on and so forth, but, you know, you just couldn't hang with me. You couldn't get into the places I frequented. Matter of fact, you couldn't even get into Disney World if you wanted. Pavam. I wasn't sure that Jayon was going to make it to adulthood even. For those of you that have known Jayon since he was a child, they know there's a term for Jayon. What's the term, Jayon?
Accident prone.
Accident prone. Jayon has spent more time in the ER than the entire family and relatives combined. Maybe that's why he pursued the career path he did. And I'm not just talking about the time that Jayon used a matchbox car as a skate on the coffee table and gashed his skull open. No. I'm not talking about the time that Jayon cut his knees open multiple times. I'm not talking about that. It wasn't just a childhood thing. Jayon went on a ski trip several years back. I told Jayon, "Jayon, how many Indian people do you know that go skiing?" He said, "Be careful." I said, "Pick something else, something warmer perhaps." So what actually happened to Jayon, he gets there the first day, rents all the nice equipment and everything. I get a text from him. "I sprained my leg. I'm going to be hanging out the lodge for the rest of the week." Well, that's what happens when you reach too high, Jayon. Much of our family prayer was dedicated towards Jayon's well-being, and thank God for that. He's here. He made it. And on top of that, Becca, God answered our prayers. He gave Jayon somebody that can take of all his medical needs. I mean, he cuts himself, he can stitch him up. He bruises himself, he can put ice back. Thank God for you. Oh, how far we come, how far we've come, Jayon. I thought he was absolutely hopeless, but with the help of yours truly and all the other gentlemen standing by your side today at the ceremony, you made it. I'm excited for you guys to start a family together. And I can't wait to see everything that's come to it's going to be seen in the coming future for you guys. So on that note, those that give glasses, I'd like to make a toast to Jayon and Becca, my new brother and sister, and me and Carmen, our family specific, are honored to be your Jachin and Chichi. We love you guys.
Good evening, everyone. I'd like to first start off by thanking my Lord Jesus Christ for what he did for me on the cross, and also for bringing Rebecca into my life and allowing for today to happen. This has been the best day of my life, and I'm so grateful that we get to share it with all of our family and friends. We especially want to express our gratitude to those of you who have traveled long distances to be here with us today. I also want to thank each and every one of our vendors. Y'all have done such an amazing job putting this place together and everything that they've done to make this day possible. I'm sure many of you know, but I've got to retell this story. I met Rebecca during a night shift on July 31st, 2015. Prior to that night, I had been praying daily for almost a year, asking God to lead me to the woman he intended for me to marry, only if marriage was his plan for my life. I asked him to lead me to a woman whose heart was so close to his that I would have to run to God in order to get to hers. Rebecca has shown me that we have a mighty God who answers prayers, and he does so in an incredible way. He has blessed me with a wife who is absolutely amazing. I came to that realization within a few hours of meeting and talking to her the very first night we met. After that night shift together, I went home and prayed about pursuing her. When I went back to work the next night and asked her out, I knew I was about to go out on my first date with my future wife. The last 16 months had just confirmed what I already knew that very first day, and I know the rest of our lives together will further strengthen my conviction. Rebecca and I see our marriage primarily as something God intends to use to bring others closer to Jesus Christ. We are far from perfect or having everything figured out, as anyone here can quickly attest. But thankfully, we serve a very gracious Father who continues to forgive us despite our shortcomings. As you all know, Rebecca and I plan on moving to Rwanda in July of next year to work with the underserved there and to share with them the good news of the gospel. Although we haven't discerned where God intends for us to be after Rwanda, we hope to continue to live a life of continual service to him. We ask that each one of you keeps us in your prayers and you hold us accountable through the years. With all that being said, we thank each and every one of you again from the bottom of our hearts for being here, and we hope that you enjoy the rest of the evening.
Just to carry on with that, we're so thankful for all of you. Thank you for spending your Thanksgiving weekend with us. You're such a blessing in all of our lives, and we're so blessed, each and every one of us. And so thank you so much for being here.
You taught me everything, everything you've given me. I always keep it inside. You're the driving force in my life. There isn't anything or anyone that I could be, and it just wouldn't feel right if I didn't have you by my side. Ooh. You were there for me to love and care for me when skies were gray. Whenever I was down, you were always there to comfort me. And no one else can be what you have been to me. You will always be. You will.
And how long have I been dreaming? Who forgot to wake? To wake me up. It sounds crazy, but Daddy, now I think that I'm in love. 'Cause when he steps in the room, my heart begins to pound. And you said, never said. You promised there was one out there for me. And it's true, I might have doubted, but he's standing here and now. Now I believe. And yes, I know you'll be proud of the man that chose me. It's elementary to the wise, for the fool in full disguise. Beggars bow, poets kneel, and as for me, it's finally real.
Let's give it up for Rebecca and her father.
That's what you are. Unforgettable. Though near or far. Like a song of love that clings to me. How the thought of you does things to me. Never before has someone been more unforgettable in every way. And forevermore, that's how you'll stay. That's why, darling, it's incredible that someone so unforgettable thinks that I am unforgettable too.
At this time, we'd like to open up the floor for couples to please join this lovely couple. Once again, grab your significant other, bring them up. Every person on this dance floor adds 10 more years to this lovely couple's happily married life.
Unforgettable in every way, and forevermore, that's how you stay. That's why, darling, it's incredible that someone so unforgettable thinks that I am unforgettable too.
Let's keep it going with one more.